we have with us Ms. Archana Mishra Ma'am, Founder Principal at Delhi World Public School, Chhattisgarh. She has 17 years of experience in education and administration and 7 years in research. She has been awarded for contribution in students' development by Asian Education Awards and as Most Progressive Coordinator by Global Education Awards. Also, Shaurya Samman Awardee in Education Segment for year 2021. It is our pleasure to have you with us, ma'am. So, ma'am, it would be great if you can tell us a bit more about yourself. And since we know that you have experience in various departments, so it would really help us to know a bit more about you.
Oh, even I am super excited for the discussion today. And Ms. Nikita, I will tell you, I normally come from a middle class segment. My parents were my career coaches, as normally it happens in most of the Indian families. And my dad, he was the one who identified that if I can do something to the core of best, it is going to be the field of teaching. And somewhere I'm grateful that yes, he identified those qualities. And teaching experience has been a wonderful experience for me. I just do not remember how this 17 years I have spent in this field. Every single day is a new challenge. Every single day gives you new learning, and that keeps you a lifelong learner. So in these 17 years, I have got all good memories. My students have they used to call me Mummy Ma'am. So this is the biggest title I have earned in my teaching career. And I always believe in experiential learning. I always practice the innovative ways of teaching in the classes, and I motivate my teachers also to do the same. I have been working, like I started my career in 2004. After 2007, when I got married, I went to Bangalore, where I got an opportunity to work with many UG and PG colleges like Presidency, AMC, TJON and all. That gave me a very good opportunity. And I was one of the counselors for Bangalore University as well. And after that, we shifted to Surat, where I got the opportunity to work in an international school, that is Tapti Valley International School, where I met my previous principal, Mr. Pannu, a very good motivator. And we had the same kind of mindset with the innovative practices in the field of teaching and all. And that's how he gave me the opportunity to become a senior coordinator. From there, my life had changed from the teaching to the coordinatorship. And now I have taken up a new position, that is principal. So currently I'm working as a founder principal in a I would not say it is a big city, it is a small town. And why I chose this particular place, I'll just take 2 minutes of yours. Why I chose this particular place, because this is a place where people from background who have a good experience and all, they always used to reject this opportunity. Why? Because this is not a very good, I would say a big city to live in. And I somewhere had a very good passion for social work. So this somewhere, inclined, and then I was like, no, this is something which I have to do. So students in their young age, you won't believe, students, those who are in grade 5 and 6, they used to leave their parents and they used to go to the nearby big cities. And I'm just trying my best to give them all such opportunities. And it is a good thing to share that within 4 months, this school has become the best school in this locality. Thank you so much.
Next, we have with us Ms. Liza Roy Malik, ma'am, principal at HL International School, Greater Noida. She's a passionate educationist with 22 years of experience in education fraternity. She's an able administrator with proven track record. She motivates and touches people's lives through talk shows, interactive sessions, and storytelling. Her motto is to give back to the society as much as she can and to be remembered for being good and grateful. We welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you. So I've had the good fortune of working with very good principals, because of whom I got groomed into an able administrator. I'd like to give the entire credit to the people with whom I have worked, the organizations with whom I've worked. So I worked with Cambridge School, I worked with Somerville, GD Goenka, Mount Litera Z School. So all of the schools have had very good impact on me as a person, as an individual. How I am, how able I am, because you know when your loved ones write your profile, they write nice things like you have read out. So, okay, so before I tell you about the talk shows and all, I would also like to second Archana ma'am. There are places, you know, which are small towns and there are very nice schools coming up and not many takers as in the leadership scenario, you know. But I have had the good fortune of working with Mount Litera Z School, which is one of the most amazing experiences of my life. Those 2 years that I spent over there are, you know, two of the two best years in my life. And now when COVID hit, what happened was that we were at home, we had a lot more time after those initial 20 days. We had our rest, we had slept a lot, we had cooked a lot, we had watched Netflix a lot, and then we were clueless as to how to invest our time. So that was one time when I thought of, you know, taking my experience to the next level if possible. And I feel very happy when I engage in interactive sessions with people. So I've been taking workshops, I take workshops for CBSE and 2-3 other publications. And at that point in time, I launched a small platform, not obviously as big as Easy Schooling, but a very tiny platform where I interact with, you know, like-minded people. I try and bring achievers to the forefront who interacting with whom leave us a lot of inputs, you know, for the children to take back home and also to follow their footsteps, you know. So there are 2 segments called Achievers Speak and Young Achievers Speak, and I'm trying to reach as many people as possible. And also later on, midway through one, we have just turned one, and midway through I decided to take it just a little further, and I started hosting debate sessions, interactive sessions, and there we have a lot of fun. So that's it. And that is something which is very close to my heart. I enjoy it doing. So that is about it.
Yes. So a big congratulations, ma'am. A big congratulations for turning one. And we really wish you all the best for future sessions as well. Ms. Neeti Dhami, ma'am, principal at the Shriram Universal School, Hisar, Haryana. A lifelong learner and passionate visionary with wide experience of 21 years in different leading schools of India under different boards, CBSE, CISEC, CAIE. Her vision is to prepare tiny toddlers towards joyful, confident, potentially skilled, self-reliant and future-ready global citizens. We welcome you, ma'am. It is a pleasure to have you with us.
Good evening and namaste to everyone. Thank you so much, Nikita, and thank you, Easy Schooling, for inviting me for this panel discussion. And I'm looking forward for that. But before that, because everybody's talking about us, and I would like to go a little bit back to my schooling, because I feel parents and children should know about a little bit how you did your schooling. That makes a lot of difference, and that gives a more impact. As schools have started maybe almost, I think, after 2 years, and we all were eagerly waiting for children to come back. And today's topic is all about technology and entrepreneurship. And I think today's child, when I looked at, I don't know, do they really need our guidance, or they know so much? Because we are just as a mentors, if we work on with them, I think that itself is enough for them. So when I go back to my childhood, I do not had all those things, gadgets and the technology and so many things. Even the phone was like you need to dial 1 and 2 and 3, and then you pick the call and then you have to do that. Then this comes, the button 1 comes. So this is how we started. But yes, taking a school principal ship, before that, I actually wanted to join the armed forces. And when I was in class 8, I was in NCC, then I went to class 12, started the volleyball, then I played the national volleyball. And then I have taken the Air Wing NCC. I wanted to go to the RD parade in Delhi. So all those things then motivated me so much with all these, okay, you are wearing uniform and then you are going for this, serving the nation. But when I've taken this as an education, because you know, you got married a little early those days and parents will not listen to you. They will do what they want to. And it's a good scenario has changed. Girls have become more independent. Girls are, I think, coming up so nicely in the all field of, not only in, you can say the doctors or the engineer, but they are in everywhere. So that was the time when I used to be in a class 8. One day, my father used to have a big scooter. I don't know how many of you know that. It was a Bajaj Chetak. Why I'm talking about this, my story, because this is how you started your learning new things. And my motto is always, it was like, when was the last time you did something for the first time? So I take it this motto as every day is learning. Okay, aaj maine kya naya sikha, what I have done something new. So this is how I have taken. So I, you know, early 5 o'clock, I used to go to the stadium for to play volleyball. It was a craze. So one day I took my father's scooter. I have learned somewhere. So I have taken the scooter and I have gone. And when I came back, he was so angry. He said, why did you take my scooter if something happens? I said, okay, sorry, I will not do it again. But yes, I have taken it again and again and again. So what I am trying to say that the children, I think nowadays have given ample opportunities. I think they just need to grab that. That's all they need. And I feel myself privileged. Yes, I have not joined armed forces or air forces, air wing, because that was there, I was with me. But yes, where I am, I think I got a larger, I can say the area or larger area to work on when I'm working with the small kids, where we can work what we need to do with them from the childhood. Because the world is going somewhere. Yes, technology, definitely we all need. We are talking about artificial intelligence, we are talking about coding. But yes, with that, there are a lot many things to be learned from the childhood. Thank you so much, Nikita.
Can you just mention the elements that your school is implementing to teach entrepreneurship to youth?
Okay, so here in this school, because it is up to grade 7 this year, and next year we are going to be up to grade 10, I would not be able to share much of the information related to this, but then yes, a few things which I have started here, I would definitely highlight, and a few things which I have already done in my past organization, the previous organization, that also I would be highlighting. So I completely agree with Abhilasha ma'am when she says that by 2055, we will have a complete different set of employment opportunities. We actually do not know how it is going to be. So when we are preparing our kids for the unknown things, I'm not very sure what the syllabus which we are teaching them, is it really going to help them out? So we will have to focus more on the skills. And what kind of skills these 21st century kids will require. So that is definitely the critical thinking skills, the brainstorming skills, the decision making thing. All these are the things which our students will require. So here in this school, right from the young age when they are in grade 4 and 5, what I have started doing is, this is something which I have learned from one of my research which I'm practicing here. And the first method I will tell you, that is brainstorming bin. And what is this brainstorming bin? So here we motivate our students to get new ideas, new business ideas, what they are going to do in future. And not only to get the ideas, but also to learn to identify what can be the requirement for it. Right? What all things will you require, and what kind of mindset you are going to require, what kind of skills you are going to require for it. So this is called as brainstorming bin, which will help them in getting the critical thinking skills, problem solving skills, and not only this, the presentation skill also get improves. Another thing is the solution boxes. This is something which I normally encounter in my day-to-day life. Most of the employees, I think all the principals will agree with this. Most of the time it so happens that teachers, they will come running to you that, ma'am, this is the problem. Hardly you will get people who are working with you, those who come with a solution. And we will have to train our students to become a person who is not a one who is more into the problems. He should be the one who gets to know about the solution. So this is the second thing which I follow in my school. This is called as solution box. where students, if they have any problem in the school, they can definitely come up with the complaints, but along with the complaints, they will have to tell me what can be the probable solution. And when I say I normally do it with the students starting from grade 4, you will be amazed to know that students of grade 4 and 5, they come up with such brilliant ideas. And most of the time we implement it and we highlight it and we send them the appreciation letter as which normally boosts their confidence. One thing which I normally do on all the Saturdays, students from grade 4 to grade 7, they attend the TED-Ed talk shows. These are the shows which normally give them a lot of confidence, which give them new ideas. And slowly and gradually, I would say I have seen students becoming more independent, more innovative, and problem solvers in all the fields. Thank you so much.
There is a lot of change which needs to be brought into our mindset. The problem is our mindset, you know. Our parents want marks, they want grades. The children are maybe these days because of COVID, they have become very highly digitally literate, but financially they are terribly illiterate, you know. Even us, many of us parents, mothers especially, many of our teachers whose accounts are being handled by their husbands, and obviously children. So very off late, just a few days ago, I got to interact with a boy, grade 11. So he came to me for some other purpose. He came to me to with some problem of his, and I started probing him a little. I got to know that he takes tuition classes, and with that money, he earns about $1,000 only. It is very surprising. He earns only 1,000 rupees per month because he is himself in grade 11. He doesn't want to bother his parents with his basic needs. So he earns that much. And out of that, 800 rupees he invests in stock. So I asked him, how did you get to know about investment, and first of all, and then into stocks? Who guides you? So we got chatting, and he told me, "Ma'am, I understood. You know, in a few months into COVID, I did understand that my parents are not in a position to support me. Rather, it's my time to support them. So I started taking classes, and then while I was taking classes, I watched a few YouTube videos. From there, I invested about 3 to 4 months in understanding what goes into it, and." Because I did not want to lose my 800 rupees. So I watched videos, I understood. And then when I was, I thought that I'm in a position, I understand things, you know, the basics at least. So I spoke to somebody, I trusted somebody with my, need, you may say, or my instincts, you may say. And after that, I started investing. I said, "Did you make any money?" He said, "Yes, ma'am. I earned a few hundred more after investing." So what he told me is amazing. After this, what he told me, then he said that, "Ma'am, I invested the second, when I got my second fees, I invested the same amount, but this time I did not want a return, an immediate return. I have started investing in long-term projects because I have, worked out that they work better. So I am not in an apparent very big need for money, just that my parents can't support me right now, and I don't need much support. I need internet, which I have. My parents have supported me. I need that for classes, and I get that." Now, the closest I have come to entrepreneurial ventures in school setup is when we did a club. We had this entrepreneurship club, and it was very successful. But that success was very short-lived. Why? Because parents did not want us to invest their children's time in gardening, in selling small bits. You know, though we made few things from paper, we made a session on paper bag making from newspapers. We were telling them, reusing, recycling, everything was fine as long as we were talking about it, you know. The moment we wanted to implement that in the school system, we got a session done on paper bag making from newspapers, and then we made puppets, and then we made small pots from plastic bottles, and we got saplings planted in them. And then for the PTM, we set up a small table, and the club children, they started selling it. That was the point when the parents felt very bad that you are making my child stand at a stall and sell them. That's not done. I'm not sending my child to an international or global school to do that. So, and that was almost the end of the club. I mean, that club particularly. So I see that when I talk about my son, I don't see him having the financial literacy that I would like him to have for his age. He's 18 plus. So he doesn't understand much, right? So off and on, just mentioning Bitcoin would not help. Understanding the concept of money, the concept of earning and spending, the concept of budget, the concept of how the house runs when the child comes to the parent asking for something, and for whatever reason, if the parent wants a little bit of time, that not exactly right now, maybe in some time, not being refused, but a little bit time is being asked. Not many children would like to understand the situation. They take offense, they feel hurt, they feel they become aggressive and whatnot. And at times they even go a little out of control. So my point is that I don't see teachers coming with that skill set to even talk to a child. I would like my teachers to sit with a child and ask his problems that they don't do. I want them to talk to them and find out their strengths, and obviously find out about their likes and dislikes that they don't do. Why they don't do is exactly what sir has said. We have a portion to finish, we have syllabus. And then the other day, I was talking to my director, saying that I want to do this council. Let's start the council because we haven't been able to do it. He said that, ma'am, let 9 to 12 be out of it, as you were mentioning, Miss Abhilasha. So you see, we are back to square one. That's the problem. We need to make the parents understand. I think rather than the teachers, we should take Bloom's taxonomy, multiple intelligence and whatnot with the parents. Make them understand first, and then maybe we will be appreciated for implementing them in the classroom setup. I didn't want to hurt anybody, but then this is the reality. And if it has hurt anybody, I think rather than feeling bad, we should work on it. Thank you.
So if everybody has worked in Haryana, yes. So I would also like to add something here. I think I should start. Yes. I will take 4-5 points here. I will start with my experience and what we did in our school, the previous school where I was. And then I will talk about a little bit what is happening in our Shree schools, how we are actually implementing these things in the our curriculum. So if I go back to my experience I was mentioning before, I used to play volleyball and go to the stadium and all. So when I was in class 11th, that time there was no coach for the girls. So one of the person in the stadium, they asked if you can coach the girls. I said, okay, fine. I did not know that end of the day I might get something, the money, monetary benefits I'll have. So yes, I have taken that just like that, but I used to get 200 rupees or sometimes 500 rupees, and this is how, the thing started in my mind, okay, this is how you can earn. So I think it all depends on the personal bringing up also, because as if I remember my parents, my father was also a school principal and he was a physics teacher. And I think the parents' background or the family background is so important, where you can go to the right path or you can go with the right thing what you want to do. And let's go back to the residential system. We used to have a tuck shop in our school. And that tuck shop used to have some biscuits and some chips or some things like that stuff. And that to the tuck shop was then only on Sundays. You can't go and buy something. And children used to get the coupons. So there also, if you want to start the entrepreneurship, it was like that. Someone was very smart to do that. And he will save his, whatever he's bought from the tuck shop, he will save sometimes. And he will sell it for the double coupons. And then this is how he used to get the next Sunday something very big. And then again, he will sell it for something more. So it all depends on children, how much the opportunities are given, how much you are able to do things. And then when the ma'am was talking about she has introduced some program in the school and the parents were not agreeing to that. So for that, I will suggest that I think in our school, Shree schools, we have a three-way handshake. So that three-way handshake, let's talk about me as a school and the child and the parent. So whatever we do in our school, we do involve parents because they are the biggest stakeholders. And there is nothing wrong telling about the what is happening in the school to them. It all depends on how you channelize your school or how you put the program to the parent. Because yes, you are mentioning that the Haryana is the biggest problem, but till now I'm not facing that kind of problem. I think once you call that, you invite parent, I think they are understanding what is happening. It's all start with the trust, I think. And it is almost for me 2 years here and things are happening in a good way. And yes, we all have faced the problems of the pandemic and the things were not very good in shape. But yes, things are coming back. And I think when I take an example of as open my account of Instagram or maybe the Facebook, where you see the young children, they are making a lot of reels now. So that or maybe they're putting something in the YouTube channel. So children are coming up and they are doing something where they can earn money. These things are also happening. And there are some positive things also happening. And when we talk about the entrepreneurship in the school, in my previous school, what we used to do that, we used to do a lot of gardening, like ma'am was also mentioning that. And those gardening, we will grow coriander and the chilies and so many other things, what children can grow, the seasonal, you can say the green leaves. And that's what we will do, we will make bundles of that. We'll make bundle and we will sell it for 15 rupees and 20 rupees or 25. At least the children are also understanding that how much, and there are two things happening in that. Because once you grow something, you sensitize children. That is more important. To sensitize the children, and then when you are selling that, I think then again it is bringing a, it's all about how much you have learned in your life or how much you have done the curriculum, how you have done the maths or science or English. At the end of the day, it comes how much you are earning. So teaching children from the childhood what how to earn, I think that we need to take it forward. And what I feel, what is happening for entrepreneurship, why you teach from the childhood. In the maths lab also, once we have put up the maths activity where the children were putting in the small stall, okay, this is for 5 rupees because we need to teach them the coins and the rupees and 2 rupees and 10 rupees and 50 rupees. So we have put up a shop there or market thing there. So again, I think in the classroom, you can actually inculcate all these things in the classroom activities also, where you can bring all these things. Because what happens in these activities, student can collaborate on a group project using technology-based tools such as, or maybe the Google Docs or Wikis or anything. The wall of the classrooms are no longer a barrier as a technology-enabled new way of learning, communicating and working collaboratively. Technology has also begun to change the role of our teachers and the learners. I think we all have learned during pandemic how important it is to come the online, and everybody has become a tech-savvy the person. And technology can also sprint by making learning more engaging, more collaborating, rather than memorizing facts. And students learn by doing and through, yes, critical thinking. We all know that this could be as simple as taking an interactive quiz in the classroom or maybe participating in any tech-enabled group and discussions. And information technology again plays a vital role. The developing, like if we have seen that during pandemic, what happens? Any metro city or any good school, children are able to take online classes. But there are some children in the rural areas who are not able to take the classes because they do not have so much of equipment, or they do not have laptop, even the mobile phones. But yes, slowly we have come to know that government is also helping, and the children started using the mobile phones and they are taking the online classes, maybe by Doordarshan or by anything else. So yes, things are happening. I am thinking it's going in a positive mode. But I feel that involving not only children alone, but yes, the society, your parent also should be involved in that. I think things can work in such a wonderful way. And what is the another program what we are integrating in our school, that is STEM-based learning. I think all of us, we know about what happens in that. In that you have a science, then technology, engineering and maths. There's so many things are there, the lessons are prepared, and that also gives you a lifelong success. Student have that problem solving abilities, creativity, innovation, and then it increases when they're integrating technology and core content areas. And as you have seen the new education policy also, now artificial intelligence and coding and all things are happening from the class 8 or 6 or 7. So I think things are changing. I'm looking at, I'm very positive about it, ki in next 2 years, scenario is going to change. Thank you so much.
What are the benefits of instilling entrepreneurship values in the children, and why students are taking much more interest towards entrepreneurship these days?
Fine, thank you Nikita for your question. I hope I'll be able to satisfy the parents when they will listen to my part of the answer at least. So see, what I understand is that we must shift our focus from curriculum and syllabus to life skills. First of all, we need to make sure that the parents understand the need for life skills more than, learning a few data. They should understand that how they are using that data and in which attitude. That makes a huge lot of difference. You know, the child may know a lot, but the child may not know how to use it or where to use it rather. So the child's self-awareness skills are very, very important. The child must feel good about himself or herself. The child must feel that, whatever skills he has got, he's appreciated for it. And however much we appreciate them in school, when the parents say a few good things, it stays with them for longer. And positive reinforcement, I don't think has ever failed, ever failed. So parents, my message to the parents will be that please sit with your children, talk to them, and try and understand what makes them happy and what is that goal that they are looking at. Maybe it is not the same with you, like what you have chosen for your child, but then at least come to a conclusion, come midway and work it out. Maybe there is a way out and both of you will be happy. So a lot of interaction between the parent and the child is required to make sure that the parents understand the challenges that the children are facing. We keep telling them that when you will be in the job market, the jobs would have changed, when you'll be in the job market, this, that, everything. So what about really the job market? The parent needs to understand that, and the parent needs to be a part of that journey when the child goes into the job market. I guess that will be all from my side. Thank you.
Okay, so I would say that parents should definitely promote their kids. They should motivate their kids to learn the different values what entrepreneurship as a subject offers. Most of the time when you talk to the parents, they will say, ki, ma'am, my child, he spends unnecessarily. Why? Because they don't understand the value of money. So entrepreneurship is something which will make them understand the value of money they have in their hand. It is also one of the problem which normally parents raise, that ma'am, bachcha kahin bhi jata hai, bahut dar jata hai, confident hi nahi hai. So this problem also will be solved. How come? Because when the child has to convince somebody, a frightened person cannot convince anybody. So entrepreneurship will definitely give you the skills where you will become more confident about the products which you have, about the services which you are going to offer, and that is really going to boost up your confidence level. And this gives you one more quality, that you start taking risk. You analyze the scenario very well and you start taking risk. So confidence level will definitely go high. Another thing is decision making. Parents say, ma'am, dekhiye, usko commerce lena hai, ya arts lena hai, ya science lena hai. He is not able to understand. These are the values which we are teaching them right from grade 9. In my case, I have started it from grade 4 onwards. It will take some time, but yes, the time they will reach to grade 10, they will be able to analyze the things and they will find out what is best suitable for them. And the last thing I will tell you, a person who is a good entrepreneur, most of the cases, they have very good PR, right? This is something which will help them to maintain a position in the society as well. So I think parents, if you are really looking up for all such things, all such qualities in your kids, then definitely you should promote the entrepreneurship skills. Thank you so much.
I'll just go a little bit from ma'am, what she said about the failures. I think I can just quote the same thing here. The children should learn how to take failures, because what we are seeing around us, because they are not able to take failures sometimes, and that is why they face a lot of problem, and that is why a lot of mental issues and health issues are mental issues. So let's not get into that. When I talk about the entrepreneurship, for me, for my message to my parent or to anyone who is watching this program, it will be like, it's very, very, very important. I think it's a high time when we should start working on that, because we need to prepare our children for the uncertain future. We do not know. Like COVID just came and we do not know what to do next, and people have started a lot of new things. So preparing our children for the uncertain future, for that, I think we really need to focus on in a very early childhood, wherever we can start with. It's not late. So I think the education, that entrepreneurship education, it adds student for all, I think, socio and economic background to think outside the box and to nurture unconventional talents and skills. And it creates opportunities, ensures social justice, instill confidence, and stimulate the economy. That is also very, very, very important. And they say India is going to be a big economy in next 10 to 15 years. So when there are going to be ample of opportunity for children. And again, the entrepreneurship education focuses on developing real world skill, what is happening in the real world. And that will help students to lead at sectional levels of the rapidly changing world. And we need to be prepared for the change, the world who's changing. And how this is a technology is going to improve in the education, it is from going from digital to the models and the traditional learning, to going to the something, a new concept they are going to learn, and that it is going to improve their communication skills, and this is going to advance the research, I think, because if they want to take that, they need to do a little bit of research on that. Without research, you cannot move ahead. And yes, effective assessments, learning at one's own pace, that is also important. And we do not have to pressurize the child, because when you are working in a team and you are learning in a fun way of learning, I think there is no pressure, and then they can learn in their own way. Because once you make something happen in the team, one is going to lead, another one is definitely going to learn. This is how they are going to learn. And a lot of online group collaboration is also happening. And these are the things I think they should take it forward. It's a teamwork which is going to work. And for tomorrow's future, I think the working in a team is very, very important. And second thing, what is going to happen, that is also very important, how to speak in a public, that is also important. And prepare an effective presentation, because if they do not prepare their presentation properly or do not present it, nobody is going to take your idea, nobody is going to listen to you. So that is again another thing. Then they have to collect a lot of data. So collecting a data, analyzing that data, and then putting it as a presentation, that is also important thing. Then use of social media, I think that is becoming a big boom. Everybody is on social media, and you should know how to use it. That is again, it's an important thing, how to learn. So I think they are learning to solve the problems of the real life problems, and maybe the complex problems, and what do you say, the definite answer is not there. They are going to find the answer from once when they are going to do it. And it's just like when you learn a cycle. When you were small, you start learning a cycle and you fall and you fall and fall again. But if you learn cycle when you become an adult, you feel, okay, how do I do it? So there are a lot of people are seeing me, I don't want to do it. But child never bothers about that. He just wants to ride a cycle, or how many times he's going to fall. So that's why I think opportunities should be given at the early age, and everyone in a society, parent, teachers, educators, everyone around, I think, should be working on that, making children self-sufficient. This is what it is required. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And definitely the team together will make the dream work. Mm-hmm.